Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praises belong to Allah the Almighty, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Peace, blessings and salutations be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his blessed companions and his family members and all those that follow them with goodness until the day of resurrection. From amongst the many things our religion Islam highlights, one thing is charity, the encouragement of charity. Allah the Almighty in the Quran, He encourages us to give in the path of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a hadith, he encourages us to give in the path of Allah. And this charity, it plays a huge part, an important role in the life of a believer. From amongst the many verses, Allah the Almighty, He mentions in chapter 2, verse 254 of the Quran, O believers, donate from what we have provided for you before the arrival of a day when there will be no bargaining, friendship or intercession. Those who disbelieve are truly the wrongdoers. So Allah tells us in this verse that we should make the most of this life by donating in His path, by giving sadaqah before the arrival of the day of resurrection, before the day of judgment, before the hereafter. Because in the hereafter, on the day of judgment, we will not be able to accumulate, acquire or gain any rewards as such in terms of donating, in terms of giving sadaqah, in terms of spending in the path of Allah. Allah mentions in chapter 57, verse 7, believe in Allah and His Messenger and donate from what He has entrusted you with, so those of you who believe and donate will have a mighty reward. So in this verse, Allah encourages us to donate. He tells us, if you donate and those who donate will have a great and mighty reward. So do not think that your donations are going in vain. Rather, Allah is rewarding you with abundant reward. And that is why He mentions in demonstration and as an example to make us understand in chapter 2, verse 261, the example of those who spend their wealth in the cause of Allah is that of a grain that sprouts into 7 ears, each bearing 100 grains. And Allah multiplies the reward even more to whoever He wills. For Allah is all bountiful, all knowing. So in this verse, Allah gives us an example to explain to us how much reward we are gaining just by giving in His path, just by donating to charity. So it is very important that we take heed to these verses and we also understand that there is great reward for us donating and for us giving towards charitable causes. Allah mentions in another verse in the Quran in chapter 2, verse 262, those who spend their wealth in the cause of Allah and do not follow their charity with reminders of their generosity or hurtful words, they will get their reward from their Lord and there will be no fear for them, nor will they grieve. So in this verse, Allah is telling us that when we donate, it is important that we donate sincerely. We donate out of our sincere hearts. We don't donate thinking that we are doing a favor for those that we are donating to. We don't donate saying hurtful things to those that we are donating to, acting as if we are doing a great favor for them, because this nullifies our rewards, this nullifies our deeds, and this is something that is distasteful in Sharia. This is something that displeases Allah the Almighty. Like the scholars mention, that when you do a good deed, bury it in the ocean and do not think about it again. You have done a good deed, it is for your own benefit, but you don't need to brag about it. You don't need to act as if you are doing a great favor for whomsoever you benefited. So it's important that we don't give reminders of our generosity and even say hurtful things to those that we are donating towards. Allah mentions in another place in the Quran, encouraging us again to donate in chapter 2, verse 267, Oh believers, donate from the best of what you have earned and of what we have produced for you from the earth. Do not pick out worthless things for donation, which you yourselves would only accept with closed eyes, and know that Allah is self-sufficient and praiseworthy. So in this verse, Allah is telling us that when we donate, we should be donating from those things that are of benefit for us and those things that we classify and consider as the best of things, not those things that we consider worthless, those things that we want to throw away, those things that we will not even use for our own selves. Rather, when we donate, we want to donate from the best of our earnings, from the best of things that we have, so that we give a good taste to those that we are donating to for the things that we are also benefiting from in good ways, in the best of ways, in the best of manners. Allah mentions in another verse in the Quran, and donate from that which we have provided for you before death comes to one of you. And you say, my Lord, if only you delayed me for a short while, I would give in charity and be one of the righteous. So in this verse, Allah is telling us that we should not live to regret. We should donate before the time of death comes upon us, because at the time of death, we may live to regret. And if we have not donated in His path, we have not given sadaqah, we have not given towards charitable causes, then we, at the time of death, it's possible we say, my Lord, if only you delayed me for a short while, only if you give me respite so that I may donate, so that I may give towards charitable causes and be of the righteous. But obviously it'll be too late when the time of our death comes. So Allah is encouraging us, donate now. Donate whilst you're alive. Donate whilst you have the chance. Donate whilst you have the wealth. Before death comes upon you, and then it is too late. And then you only are living to regret. And you only regret at that time, and obviously it's too late. If we look into the hadith, then we find ample narrations where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he encourages us to donate. He informs us of the importance of donating, the significance of charity. Imam Muslim mentions in his compilation an authentic narration, and Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu has reported this, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when the human being dies, his deeds end except for three: ongoing charity, beneficial knowledge, or a righteous child who prays for him. So when we pass away, then all our good deeds and our actions will cease. Everything will stop. We cannot do no more good deeds. However, if there are any avenues through which our good deeds will carry on in our graves, then there are three avenues that the Prophet tells us of. The first avenue is ongoing charity. So if we have donated towards charitable causes in our life before passing away, such causes that are ongoing, that are perpetual, the fruits of which that are lasting, then even in our grave we will be receiving rewards, we will be receiving the benefits. And then Allah mentions the second avenue, beneficial knowledge that we have left behind, and people are benefiting from that knowledge even after we pass away. And the third avenue is that we leave behind a righteous child who prays for us. Then this is also an avenue that will benefit us in our graves. So we need to seriously take heed from this narration. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also mentions that every morning two angels descend. One of them says, O Allah, give him who spends something in place of what he spends. So an angel makes dua every morning if you donate and if you give towards charity. And then another angel says, O Allah, give destruction to him who withholds. So another angel, he's making this bad dua for an individual that has the ability to donate, to give towards charity, but he's not donating. So this angel says, O Allah, give destruction to him who withholds, who's being stingy. So it's important that we understand the importance and significance of donating when we have the ability. Allah has blessed us with wealth, then it is very important that we donate towards charitable causes. We help the poor and needy. We help those that are in need of our wealth, our clothes, our food, and whatever Allah has blessed us with in abundance. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, encouraging us to donate, mentions The upper hand is better than the lower one, i.e., the spending hand is better than the receiving hand. And begin charity with those who are under your care. And the best charity is that which is given out of surplus. And he who asks Allah to help him abstain from the unlawful and the forbidden, Allah will fulfill his wish. And he who seeks self-sufficiency will be made self-sufficient by Allah. So Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this narration is telling us that the upper hand is better than the lower hand, i.e. spending is better than receiving. So spending in the path of Allah, giving sadaqah is better than receiving sadaqah. So we should be spending as much as possible according to our means, according to whatever Allah has blessed us with. As we know, our deen, our religion is very unique. It doesn't just take into consideration humans, but it also takes into consideration animals, and it also takes into consideration all of our environments that we are living in and everything from amongst creation. And in relation to this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he tells us a wonderful thing. He says, no Muslim plants a tree or sows seeds and then a bird or a human or an animal eats from it, but that is charity for him. So even if we plant a tree, a tree that bears fruits, or we sow seeds, and birds benefit from whatever we have planted from the tree, from whatever we have planted from the seeds and whatever sprouts out from that, and a human benefits, or even an animal benefits and eats from it, then this is charity. So even feeding animals is charity for us. So this is how beautiful our religion is, that it rewards us for even feeding animals, and this is also a means of charity, and we can also donate in such causes. As we all know, on the day of resurrection, we will be in need of the shade from the throne of Allah the Almighty, and that is why it comes in a hadith that the believer's shade on the day of resurrection will be his charity. So charity that we give in this life will be a means of shade for us on the day of resurrection, and the shade will be something people will be seeking. As we all know, as humans and as believers living in this world, we believe that we go through tests, we go through testing times, we go through difficulties, we are faced by calamities and afflictions. And it is for this reason the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, give charity without delay, because it stands in the way of calamity. So it gets rid of calamities, it repels calamities. So we should understand and take heed from this narration that by giving in charity, we can get rid of the calamities that we are faced by and that befall us. I pray Allah the Almighty give us the ability to understand the importance, the significance of sadaqah, and the importance and significance of giving in charity, giving in the path of Allah. I pray Allah the Almighty give us the ability to make the most of giving in charity, especially in this blessed month where our rewards are multiplied, and especially where we have a strong possibility of falling into the night of Qadr, and the night of Qadr could take place. It could have taken place, but it can still take place in the next coming nights or so. So we need to take heed. We need to make the most of these remaining nights of Ramadan and give towards charity, because even if we donate £1 in the path of Allah on the night of Qadr, then we will get reward equivalent to better than 1,000 months. So it's as if we donated for more than 1,000 months, for more than 83 plus years. I pray Allah give us the ability to act upon everything that has been said. Ameen wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.